Hey everybody. Well, it's September 3rd. It's about 2:30 in the afternoon. Give you another update on the sweet feed and let you know what's going on. So I'm going to sit here. I'm going to eat some dinner a minute real quick. That way I don't have to eat at 10:30, 11 o'clock tonight. But I got on the forums, or I checked out the forums, and I checked out some of the comments up there, and also talked to a couple of friends of mine that have been out in the field and know what's going on. And it seems like everybody's in the same boat. If you kind of look at what happened over this past week, kind of as far as, you know, like the status of the herd or status of what's going on with the elk. You know, a week ago, Friday before season, at least in this area, the elk were still in very large groups. I mean, we had 150, 200 head of cows and calves, and then 20, 30 bulls in there. It was still a big party. Everybody was bugling, carrying on. You go to 2 days after that, and a lot of the bugle and carrying on had kind of subsided, but the elk were still there. They were a little bit more loosely scattered, feeding more in the evenings rather than out all day on opening day. I mean, the elk were out in groups and bugling all the way until about 9:30 in the morning. Come about Monday, though, it was early mornings and late evenings that they were out. They were all scattered. 2 days after that, most of the elk had busted up into multiple different little groups and had already left, you know, most of them had already started to leave the general area that they had been in, to the point now where today, a week after, you know, well, basically almost, yeah, 7 days into the season, the same area that had all those cows and calves and all those bulls in it, now as of last night, had one herd bull, two satellite bulls, and about 40, 50 cows in the area. And the satellite bull was, or excuse me, the herd bull, he only bugled from about 5:30 in the evening until about 8:30. About as soon as it got dark enough to where I needed to use a headlamp, all the bugling, everything stopped. The satellite bulls in the area had bugled maybe a couple times, but most of the vocalizations stopped, and there was nothing all night last night, and there was nothing this morning. So it sounds like there's a bunch of people in the same boat. This is just what we're dealing with as far as this kind of stage in the rut, if you will. I just kind of call it that limbo period where everything's in a holding pattern right now. The elk have scattered. They busted themselves up. The big bulls are focused around, or starting to get focused on the cows, but the cows are not receptive yet. So this herd bull that I had last night, he was trying to control about 20 cows, but the rest of them, I mean, it was just a loose, you know, grouping of these cows. And even though he was going from cow to cow checking them out, they really didn't, you know, pay much attention to him, except when I tried to bugle at him a little bit and give him a little bit of bull vocalizations. Then he was able to round about 20 of them up and push them up into the alpine, out in the open a little bit more, and then stand there between them and where he heard me calling from, just kind of stood there and looked. So there's not a lot of vocalizations going on, so what are we going to do? Well, here's what I've been doing. Because these elk have scattered, because they're pretty quiet, and I have not had any success so far. I have not heard anything or seen very much in the mornings. Everything's already in the timber by the time daybreak is even remotely close to, you know, where I can glass out there. I have just been burning boot leather, trying to figure out where the elk are, spending the evenings trying to use that late evening period to figure out where the elk were. If I'm in position like I was last night, or close enough to where I could get into position, I worked them. But tonight I'm going to go back, and since I haven't heard a peep all day today, I'm going to go back to that area, back to where he was, where that bull had been, where he'd come out with all his cows. My focus tonight is to stay right close to where there's a bunch of wallows in there, and when I watched that bull come out last night, he focused about 30 minutes of the first, when he stepped out of the timber, the first 30 minutes of his activity was just thrashing the heck out of the wallow, and with it hot and sunny like it is today, I have a feeling they're probably going to do the same thing. So I'm going to go back and try to get in position of that wallow if the wind is going to cooperate, and try to get in tight close to where I know the elk activity has been, and try to use strategic calling from there. If you don't know where the elk have been, then I'd say cover country. Cover country and get yourself into some good vantage points to where you can listen into several different areas in the evening and see if you can't pick up those bugles. Once you pick them up, beat feet down there, or at least try to make visual eye contact of where those elk are talking, and then either get in there that evening or make a game plan for the next day. Until we get a little bit more closer to the middle of the month and some of those cows start becoming receptive, it's going to be tricky. We've got to be in the right place at the right time and burning boot leather and getting into strategic areas where you can listen and pick up that one or two vocalizations is going to pay off on helping you figure out where you need to be and get yourself in position. So send more updates as I get them, but that's the plan for tonight. I'm going to go back over there, see if I can't get on that bull and see if we can't work them again. So for all those that are still out there like me, still hunting, good luck. And for those that have already filled their tag, congratulations. We'll see if we can't get her done tonight.